Awesome. Don't say anything.
Every time, it's amazing.
Why don't you just start showing up 20 minutes later and make my life a whole lot easier?
But then I would miss this adorable groveling entrance that I always seem to get.
Here you go.
Look at that.
Wow. Enjoy.
So, are you ready?
You read it.
I did. You, my friend, you're a fucking genius. This is amazing. This is so incredible, honey. I can't believe you wrote this. Where on earth did you get the material for this thing?
Life.
That's incredible to me. Whose exactly?
I borrowed some of it, but mostly mine.
Really? Oh my God.
I turned out pretty well, didn't I?
Yeah, you did, have to say.
Thank you very much.
Oh. I just can't believe I would agree to marry somebody I know so little about.
You know all the important stuff, honey.
Yeah, apparently not the interesting stuff, but we're just gonna let that one go.
I love you, honey. Thank you. But that's enough about me. Let's talk about you and this audition. What happened?
Oh, I don't know.
What, not good?
No, it was fine.
What, you don't want to jinx it? Or you...
It's just, you know, when you're sitting in a room and you're going over your lines and you're with all these other girls and you're sort of trying not to check each other out, but of course you are, and
I don't know, I just suddenly started thinking, you know, there must be something more meaningful or important that I could be doing with my life.
No, please don't think like that. This is the pursuit of worldwide recognition. That's what it is. It's either this or suburban drudgery.
Those are my choices. Well, that point of view aside, actually, I think I did pretty good.
Proud of you, babe.
Thank you.
There you go, I'll take that one. You guys are ready.
Let's go. You know what I want to do? I think I want to go see a movie. I want to go see the silliest, the most star-packed, the most aggressively marketed piece of Hollywood banality that's out there right now.
I feel this way sometimes myself. And I would love to go with you, honey, but I can't. I have to go back to work.
Oh, come on. You can play hooky.
Not today. There's a big meeting.
You are such a poser.
So you finally talked to your mom?
Mm-hmm.
What'd she say?
It's about fucking time. That woman.
But she's happy about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so.
And we're gonna invite her?
Yeah. Why not? Put her in the back. But you know, I have to give her credit. She did say one nice thing. She said I could have done a lot worse. She's right, you know.
You know what? Fuck it. Let's go see the movie.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah. Take care of this. You eat that.
I'll eat it. I promise.
You ever grab a paper? I'll grab a cap.
Thank you.
I'm sorry I'm late.
Have a seat.
Thanks.
Make yourself comfortable.
Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you.
You have any trouble getting here?
No, it was fine. I took the back roads mostly, so.
So, I need to get a little background here. And so I'm going to ask you a couple of questions and then we'll get right into it. Is that okay?
That's good.
So, how old are you, Laura?
34.
And where are you from?
Texas.
Texas? Really? I don't hear that in your voice.
Yeah, I moved to Pennsylvania when I was 5.
Is that where you grew up?
Mm-hmm.
Your parents still married?
No, they divorced when I was 7.
And any siblings?
I have an older brother. He lives in Arizona. I don't see him very much. He works on planes.
I see you're married.
Yeah. 8 years in September.
Any kids?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one. My son Brian. He's 8.
Do you work, Laura?
No, I stopped working right around the time I had my son.
And what does your husband do?
Insurance. He has his own company.
And is this your first marriage?
Mm-hmm. I was engaged once, though.
Well, I think that's enough for now, so. What do you want to talk about, Laura?
I don't know. What are we supposed to talk about?
You.
Me, huh? Okay. Let's talk about me.
That was a great meal, honey. What'd you put in the chicken?
Salt.
A little galloping gourmet. Mm. Just the right amount.
Mm. Glad you liked it.
See what Bob told me?
Bob?
He's my partner, honey.
Oh, God, I'm sorry, baby. What did Bob tell you?
He thinks that Sandy is fucking somebody.
Really?
You're not surprised?
Should I be?
I was.
Well, if I was married to an asshole, I'd be fucking somebody too.
That's not nice.
You don't think he's an asshole?
No, I don't.
He's an asshole?
No, he's not an asshole. He's a tad self-righteous, I'll give you that.
He's an asshole.
Whatever.
So who's she fucking?
He doesn't know. He thinks it may be a friend.
A partner, maybe?
That's funny because I'm the partner. Yeah, that's good. He did ask my advice.
What'd you tell him?
Told him he should go fuck somebody too.
That was thoughtful.
said.
What? Really?
Really.
Who? You
ready for this? Janet.
Janet.
Oh, my God, honey. Janet, our secretary.
Oh, God. Wow, that is so original. Mm. And make him feel better?
No.
Imagine that.
Okay, smarty pants. Your friend comes to you, she says, my husband's fucking somebody. What's your advice?
Chop it off.
Oh, my God. You answer too quick. Good night.
Good night. Sweet dreams.
Now I will.
This slime ball or something.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she really didn't want to get married to him, but then they stopped the whole marriage thingy. They crashed the party. And
what do you mean, they crashed the party? They saved her?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. And that's tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Good, good. Well, listen, kid, you be good. All right, yeah, kiss, please. Thank you. Yeah.
Hey, Paul, how you doing?
I'm good. Listen, big favor.
What's up?
Any way I could get you to pick Michelle up for me after school today? I got a big meeting I can't wiggle out of.
Yeah, no problem.
Are you sure?
Yeah, of course. Don't worry about it.
God, you're a saint. I gotta run. We'll catch up later. How's Mark?
He's great.
Give him my best.
I will.
So I'm going out of town next weekend.
Okay.
Where you going, honey?
Where you going, honey?
I'm going to Cleveland, honey.
Why are you going to Cleveland, honey?
I've got an insurance seminar. Bob thinks we're falling behind the times. I just hope there's a bar within walking distance of that hotel, because after 9 hours of listening to insurance experts pounding their chests and screaming to a microphone, I'm gonna need a drink. What did you say?
Hmm?
Did you just say go fuck yourself?
No.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Hey, Laura? Is it me?
Is what you? No. No, it's not you.
What is it then? It's been over a month.
Has it really?
Yes.
You want a blowjob?
Okay. I saw something really sad on the way to work today.
What's that?
It's a box of puppies.
Hmm?
Box of puppies. This Spanish girl giving away these puppies on the side of the road, but she wasn't getting any takers. I almost took one. What do you think?
About what?
Getting a puppy.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
We're not getting a dog.
Why not?
Because I would be the one taking it for walks and picking up the shit.
I would help.
Would not?
Would too.
It's not happening.
Well, what if no one takes them?
Well, then they get sent to the pound and are spared the abuse of angry young boys.
You're evil.
And you're a sap.
No, I'm compassionate. I'm kind. I'm
mindful of the pain and suffering of your fellow mutt, yeah.
Evil.
Sap.
Bitch.
Isn't there a more meaningful cause that you can punish yourself over?
This cause is right in front of me.
They all are, if you choose to look.
How profound.
Do you want this blowjob?
No.
Last chance. Going. Going.
All right. Love puppies.
Can I help you with something?
What?
Are you okay?
You okay, Mom? Mom?
Mm-hmm.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
How come you're not talking?
Because I'm driving.
Can't you do both?
I guess I can. What do you want to talk about?
I don't know.
How's school?
It's good.
Yeah? Any cute girls?
Couple.
Just a couple. Not keeping you from work, though, right?
No. I promise.
This happened before.
Yeah. Lots of times.
Same dream every time?
No. They're always violent, though. You know, plane crashes, fires, floods. One time I dreamed that I killed my son. He was eating breakfast and he was singing a song that he learned in school, and I walked up behind him and I put my hands around his neck.
Thoughts about suicide, Laura?
Not recently, no.
Yeah, that's not gonna be a problem. I know. Oh, Joe, hang on one second. Hi.
Hi, I'm sorry to bug you. Paul, I think Michelle left this in the car yesterday.
Thank you. We were wondering where that went.
Sure. Better get back to Joe.
Okay. Thanks, Laura.
Bye.
Yeah, my kid.
Sure it's in here? Mm-hmm. Okay. Laura?
Yeah?
What's this?
What's what? Those are panties.
I know they're panties. What are they doing in your purse?
They were uncomfortable, so I took them off. Why?
Nothing.
Aww. That is so cute.
What's so cute?
Honey, you just did a little jealous thing.
Whatever.
Come on over here. Get over here. Thank you.
Just go, you slut.
Okay.
Mark, you got some nice caps. Mark, are those capped?
Oh, boy, they capped.
Nice choppers.
My family's born with wonderful teeth.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. Canines. Speaking of canines. Later. I've been meaning to ask you this, and it's kind of work-related. You guys want a puppy?
I sympathize. He wouldn't leave me alone about those goddamn dogs.
Yeah, but do not
I'm
live
telling
with
you.
Him.
Oh, Bob.
Laura won't let me. Please take one.
Who is that?
I haven't heard about this.
Who either. Is that?
Of course you didn't have heard about it. If I had, you knew about it, I'd have to take one home, and then we'd have to raise it, and it'd be a little...
But what are you doing?
I'm afraid they were sent to the pound and gassed.
Oh, my God. No, I'm not listening to this. That is terrible. How
that's
do you
only
say
by
that,
honey?
No,
no, you are both going to hell.
Yeah, we figured that out a long time ago.
We did.
No, next subject.
Clearly by you.
No dogs, no insurance, no dogs who need insurance.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's really
good.
This is a party of six, correct? Because you two are making me nervous.
Oh, I didn't have anything to add to the dog conversation.
What dog conversation? We're not talking about dogs. Anything. Just talk about anything.
I don't want to tell them.
This is sounding very good.
This is not a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Will somebody tell them?
We're having a baby.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you wouldn't even tell us that.
Congratulations. That's wonderful.
Thank you. Surprise.
That's wonderful.
It was a plan, not by us anyway.
Well, you know, some things you can't plan, darling.
Well,
cheers.
That is so great.
Let's go, guys.
Congratulations, guys.
Thank you, huh?
Absolutely. The babies are loving the same technology. It's a lovely thing. I take it you're not drinking, huh, Ma?
Yeah.
I'll
take your dogs.
Bob. Mark tells me that you're fucking your secretary. It's, Janet, right? I think it's hilarious. I don't know why this cracks me up so much.
Did you know that Teddy Roosevelt's wife and mother died on the same day in the same house? His mother had cancer and his wife was giving birth, and he kept running up and down the stairs in between the two of them. And they died within an hour of each other.
Really?
Yeah. Know what he did? He grabbed the gun and went buffalo hunting in Montana for an entire year. I don't know. I guess I'd want to go on a killing spree, too.
Laura, what's going on?
Hmm?
You didn't come in here to talk about Teddy Roosevelt.
Yeah, I guess not. bills are paid. The garbage is collected. The streets are plowed. My husband is kind and considerate. My son is beautiful. He's happy. He's healthy. And I don't have a single reason to complain. Which is probably why I don't. How can everything be right and still feel so wrong? Anyway. Enough of that. Next subject.
What about Chris?
What?
Do you want to talk about Chris?
Incredible. All right. What do you want to do? You want to work the crowd? You want to get something to eat? What do you want to do?
Anything?
Anything.
Uh-oh. Milkshake.
Awesome. Milkshake it is. Cool.
You were so good. Here tonight, and she said you were amazing. She's going to give you an A.
Paul?
Hey, guys.
Awesome. You got the milkshake.
That was you.
Something?
Michelle, you were terrific.
Right?
Really great.
I didn't teach you how to dance.
I had a family. Oh, here they are.
Hey.
Hey. Nice work, Rabbi.
Great job, Ryan.
Yeah, you did good too.
You were wonderful, Michelle.
So listen, we're going out for milkshakes. You guys want to come?
You sure, honey? You gotta get up early tomorrow.
Not that early.
Come on, it'll be fun.
All right, it's gotta be a quick one.
Hey!
You know, Laura used to be an actress.
Really?
I dabbled.
Dabbled my foot. She was on the New York stage.
Supporting roles off Broadway hardly qualifies as the New York stage. I did a lot more auditioning than acting in those days, and not much of that, really.
She loves to downplay it, but you get a few drinks in her, and she'll do some monologues that'll knock your socks off.
How's that shake coming on?
It's just fun. Looks like our little man's gonna take after his mom. So, Paul, where you been hiding yourself? I haven't seen you at the gym in ages.
Oh, yeah, between work and Michelle, I just haven't had a whole lot of time.
You still with the same company?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
How'd you get that cut?
What?
The cut on your eye.
Oh, I...
So, can I get you folks anything else?
No, I think we're set. Thanks.
No, I got it. It's on me.
Are you sure?
Just a couple of milkshakes. Besides, I invited you.
Okay, I'll get the next one.
that's not gonna be a problem. I know it. Oh, Joe, hang on one second.
Hi.
Hi, I'm sorry to bug you. Paul, I think Michelle left this in the car yesterday.
Thank you. We were wondering where that went.
Sure. Better get back to Joe.
Okay. Thanks, Lauren.
Bye.
Yeah, my kid. Okay? What's wrong?
That must have been hard.
Yeah. Yeah, it was hard. But those last few years were by far happiest together. I guess you hear that all the time.
Hear what?
Just stories about people finding out they're gonna die. All of a sudden you stop sweating the little things and just start enjoying the hell out of life. I was alone with her the night that she died. She reached out and grabbed my hand and said, very simply, I'm going to die tonight, Paul. You'd think I'd try and talk her out of it, but her eyes were so convincing. I just knew she was right. I started to cry. I was bawling like a little child. And all she did was smile. After a while, I was smiling too. And then we both began to laugh. And a few hours later, she was gone.
Otherwise, you need a map and a machete to find your way through that thing.
Oh, God. Are you going tonight?
Yeah, I'm going.
What are we gonna do?
We'll just try and avoid each other, I guess.
Hey.
Why don't we sit on the left side of the theater and you sit on the right?
That sounds good to me.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait. Can I sit on the left?
Yeah, sure, why?
Because that's where all of Michelle's scenes are. I mean, if she looks up and doesn't see me, I'm never gonna hear the end of it.
That's fine.
Thanks. So, what do you want to do now?
I was thinking.
Yeah.
I'd like to fuck.
Oh, God, again?
Mm-hmm.
That's like all we ever do is fuck.
Is that a complaint?
No, I'm not complaining. I just thought that maybe for once we could have a conversation.
Well, we talk.
Yeah, we talk. We talk. We exchange pleasantries. We rip each other's clothes off, and we start humping like orangutans. That's very good. Would you like your banana? No, you can't. I want to talk.
Oh, gosh. A conversation.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah?
You first.
Why me?
No, it's your idea. I guess there's something you want to talk about.
Oh, not really.
Cool. Let's fuck.
No, okay. I got it. We each get to ask each other a question.
A question?
Yeah. The catch is, it has to be very personal.
This is stupid.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. Come on, we can try a new position. I bought the boots. Later,
you can put the boots on. Oh, I'll go first, okay? I'll go first.
All right.
Would you ever consider leaving Mark for me?
Saved.
I'll be right back.
Who's this?
It's Billy.
What is he doing here?
I told him to come.
Why?
I thought it'd be fun.
Are you serious?
I'm serious. Stay there. What's wrong? It was a surprise. I just thought you'd be excited.
You know what, Laura? When it comes to sex, I'm about as open-minded as you get. If you had said to me, Paul, I would really like to take a piss on you, I'd probably say, okay, let me grab a towel. But this, I mean, there's some lines that even I won't cross.
And what lines are those?
He is a fucking child.
No, he's not. He's 18. Billy, how old are you?
17.
Whatever, he's not a child.
You're slipping, Laura.
You know what I find interesting, Paul?
Oh, I can't imagine.
You have absolutely no moral objection to fucking your friend's wife.
Don't! Don't start with that. As a matter of fact, I do. I do have a moral objection to fucking my friend's wife. So forgive me if I don't want to add to my list of morally objectionable behaviors.
So what's one more? It's just a tiny one.
I think I'm gonna go.
Bye!
Stop! Stay there!
camera? Did you?
Yes.
What camera?
The video camera. We're gonna tape it, we're gonna get crazy, and it's gonna be great. It's not funny, Paul.
You're right. It's not funny. It's sick. And it's demented. Just like you.
You motherfucker! Fucker! Piece of shit! Fuck! Fucking! Fuck you! Fuck!
I'm gonna go into the backyard and have a smoke. By the time I get back, you two sick fuckers better be gone.
I don't know how he does it. Paul, I don't know how he does it.
What do you mean?
He's raising Michelle on his own, living the way he does. I can't say how many times I've tried to set him up, but it never seems to work out. I guess he'll figure it out someday.
Yeah.
How we doing back there, champ?
Tired.
I will be home soon.
I'm a little embarrassed to admit that this is the first date I have been on in over a year.
Should I be worried?
No, I think I remember what to do. I think I pay the bill, chew with my mouth closed, I crack off a joke or two.
That, yeah.
Improvise the rest. Yeah.
That's what I was told, so.
So I've never been asked out on a date before. This is a first.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. How does it feel?
No, I mean, there are those voices that creep into your head. I should be asking her out, those voices. That's okay. And you?
Well, I guess I have a few voices of my own. I, you know, was thinking, God, you must think that I'm lonely and desperate. And, but, you know, you said yes with such enthusiasm that made it easier.
You're hard to turn down.
Well,
do you mind if I ask why you did ask me out?
Because I'm lonely and desperate.
I should know better than to go fishing for compliments.
Cheers.
Cheers. To,
First dates.
First dates, yeah.
Hmm. So, this book that you seem so eager to start writing, you must be exploring some pretty dark terrain then.
Yeah.
Is this your first book?
Mm-hmm. It's my first big one. I've written some short stories and some other things along the way, but nothing this big. But what about you? You're an actress. You're not timid with men, clearly. what else?
What do you want to know?
Tell me about the journal.
The journal. Those are for morning pages. Do you know about this? Mm-hmm. I'm reading a book that plugs the idea that you should spend the first hour when you wake up writing down your thoughts. No filters, no distractions, just everything makes it to the page. Anyway, they say it's supposed to do amazing things for you.
What kind of amazing things are you looking for?
Different things, I guess.
What is your religion?
The one you taught me.
Ah, then you believe in God.
Are you going to baptize me?
What? You aren't baptized? You are doomed. You'll roast day and night and day until the most beautiful she-devils are chosen to entice you. But they'll be pushing red hot irons up your ass.
You said I could have heaven.
Child, how little you know of life.
Hear my confession.
So that was absolutely the strangest thing I've ever seen in my life.
yeah, that's what they call absurdist theater.
Yes, I understand that now. So did he kill his mother? Is that?
Yeah.
That's part of it?
Yeah, no,
and that wasn't just a game that you guys did then?
No, that was real. And that was part of the games were to bring that out and to sort of, you know, get him to be able to tell that story and smashed her head in with a hammer.
It's really lovely.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm the biggest fucking loser on this earth. Fuck me.
Wait, what are you talking about? What's the matter, Laura?
I'm so fucking disgusted with myself right now. I've been looking forward to you coming to this play for a fucking week now.
Honey.
I just really wanted to do a good job for you.
You were so amazing in that play.
It wasn't funny. It was awful.
You were absolutely fantastic. Everyone in that theater was blown away by you, honey.
You don't have to
honey,
say that.
No,
baby.
I'm not saying it to make you feel better, because it's obviously not working. Honey, you were amazing. You were amazing in there. I was blown away. I had no idea what to expect walking in there. I'm a little bit in shock from the play, and that's why I didn't say anything sooner. I'm sorry, honey.
No, you don't have to be sorry. I just fantastic. Didn't want you to be embarrassed.
Oh, my God, no. Oh,
my
let's
God.
Go celebrate. Let's get you a bottle of wine, okay?
And a scotch.
Absolutely. Whatever you need, honey. You're amazing. I promise. I've never seen anything like it. Okay? But my balls are freezing. Can we please go inside? You're fantastic. I'm gonna clear off the mantle, babe. Put some statues on there.
Oh, God. It's such a weird fucking play, and it was a weird night, and it was off, and...
You were not off. You didn't miss a single beat. It was fantastic.
Honey, I can't understand you. What? Hold on. Just slow down. Where are you? Okay, no, I'll be right there. Just stay where you are. I'll be right there. Okay. Bye.
Could I have one of those, too?
Thanks.
What about you? You want a fresh one?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Maybe. Whatever. Thanks.
You're welcome. So, want to talk to me?
I've already said it all, I think.
In Chinese.
You know, I came this close. I came this fucking close to lighting the fucking thing on fire.
Why?
Because it's an unreadable piece of shit. That's why. It's unreadable.
You read it?
Yes.
I thought you said you were gonna let me read it first.
Well, I changed my mind. You know, it's just... I see it all so clearly now. 10 years from now, annoyingly supportive wife. Two uninteresting, overweight children running around a house in the suburbs. All the available channels, two-car garage. Fuck that.
Question.
Ask.
Can I be the annoyingly supportive wife?
you proposing?
Maybe.
Where's the ring?
Hey. I believe in you.
Doesn't do me any good if I don't believe in myself.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. You're weird.
Are you feeling better?
Not really.
Sorry, you want a napkin? Hold on a sec.
So Frank Chance died today.
Who's that?
Frank Chance.
Mm-hmm.
He was this a ball player from 1900s. He died. I read about it in the paper today.
Hmm.
Is this interesting? I mean, it's gonna go somewhere.
Go ahead.
So I was just reading about him in the paper and. He played for the Chicago Cubs way back when, and he wasn't famous for hitting home runs or for strikeouts or anything like that. He was just a first baseman. But the thing about it was, he played with these two other guys, Joe Tinker and Johnny Evers.
Mm-hmm.
And when any time these three guys would step out on the field, the other team would just start to tremble.
Why is that?
I ripped out the article because the broadcaster from back then wrote a poem that sums it up. These are the saddest of possible words. Tinkers to Evers to Chance. A trio of bear cubs and fleeter than birds. Tinkers to Evers to Chance. Ruthlessly pricking our gonfalon bubble, making a giant hit into a double. These words that are heavy with nothing but trouble. Tinkers to Evers to Chance.
Okay.
It's my life.
I don't get it. Explain.
Every time I've done something great, every time I'm convinced that I've hit a home run, somebody jumps right into the air and fucking snatches it. Tinkers to Evers to Chance. Every fucking time.
Bad analogy.
Why?
Because for one, you're still a bat. A strike does not constitute an out. One strike does not constitute an out, as far as I know. And you know what? It's not even a strike, because as far as I'm concerned, until somebody else has read it, you haven't even stepped up to the plate. First pitch is going to be a grand slam. Mark my words. Promise you.
You can't go around promising shit like that.
Well, fuck it. I just did.
You marry me?
What?
Will you marry me?
Didn't I just propose to you 20 minutes ago?
Yeah, but you're just messing around. I'm serious. Will you marry me?
Stop that.
No. I'm serious. I got like a ring and everything. You want to
stop? Stop that. Don't.
Why?
Because, well, you know, we're at a burger stand for one. And, I don't know, we're talking about dead baseball players and
this isn't how you picture it? You thought there'd be sunset? Ocean view, maybe? Postcoital?
I don't know, maybe. Kind of.
The funny thing is, Laura, I've been carrying this ring around with me for a week. Just waiting. Waiting for that perfect moment.
This
is it. I've never been so sure of anything. This is it. And what they say is true. Moments choose us. We don't choose them.
Never heard of that one before.
Look at me. Look at me, Laura.
I hate you.
I hate you more. I promise.
Good morning.
Hi.
Can I have this?
Yeah, of course.
Thanks. How you feeling?
A little better.
Can I read you something?
Right now?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I thought that was just for you.
My first journal entry. Lots to write about. So, where to begin? I met this guy at the bookstore yesterday. His name is Chris. Very cute, very funny. Doesn't really try to be, though. I hope I'm doing this right. That's what it said, just write whatever comes. Anyway, this guy Chris. We went to dinner last night. He's a writer, about to start his first book. Afterwards, we went back to his place and made love. I told myself I wouldn't, but it all felt so right. It still does. At one point during dinner, two bottles into the night, He was in the middle of a story, and I thought to myself, I'm gonna marry this guy someday. There you go again. It's no wonder they all leave. I don't know if I can handle another broken heart. One step at a time. There's the phone. Could it be?
Wasn't me.
Maybe.
Kids, we're gonna have hot shots.
One step at a time.
Can I help you with something?
What?
Are you okay?
I need to fuck you.
Is this an isolated incident?
No.
So this kind of thing happened often?
What do you mean by often?
More than 5 times?
Definitely. Yeah.
More than 10 times?
I think so. You know, one thing I found interesting? Nobody refused.
How did this kind of behavior make you feel, Laura?
It didn't.
Did you have sex with any of these men more than once?
Only Paul.
Why Paul?
I don't know.
To say. I must still be in shock. I guess we had very different ideas of what was going on here. You were obviously just having fun. All
I made the mistake of falling in love with you. Laura, believe me, the last thing I want to do is break up a family. But I love you so much. I'll do whatever it takes. Tell me what I have to do. Do you love me?
Yeah, okay. Thanks.
What's wrong?
It's Paul. He's missing.
What?
Michelle came home from school, and he was gone. No note. Nothing.
Do you love me?
Thank you.
killed Paul? Did I run away? I just don't think I know what's real anymore. When I was young, you know what I used to believe? I used to believe that good things happen to good people.
You don't believe that anymore?
No.
What do you believe?
Lots of things. I believe that we have hardly any control over our destinies. I believe that people are selfish. I believe that most people live unfulfilled lives.
Any comforting ones?
A few, maybe. I know I love my son, so I guess you could say I believe in love.
What about happiness, Laura?
What about it?
Do you believe it's possible?
I guess so. But I think it's fleeting.
Thank you.
Sometimes I wish I believed in God.
Why?
I don't know. Those that do, they seem less afraid. They just seem to know what they want out of life.
What do you want out of life, Laura?
I knew you were gonna ask that. What do I want out of life? I think I'd like to stop feeling so much pain.
Have you ever thought about keeping a journal?
In the chilly hours and minutes of uncertainty, I wanna be in the warm of your love and mine, to feel you all around me, to take your hand along the sand. Oh, but I may as well try and catch the wind. When sundown bends the sky, I wanna hide away behind your smile. Never when I look your eyes I'd find. For me to love you now would be the sweetest thing. 'Twould make me sing. Oh, but I may as well try and catch the wind. When rain has hung leaves and tears, I want you near to kill my fear, to help me leave all my blue behind. For standing in your heart is where I want. Try and catch the wind. try to catch the wind. Mm-hmm. Oh, I may as well try.